Getting new reports this morning that U.S. investigators may actually get a chance to question Osama bin Laden's wives, although Pakistan is now saying that they haven't received a formal request from the U.S. just yet. But here's the question. What could bin Laden's wives possibly tell us? Michael Balboni is a former Homeland Security Advisor to President Obama. Okay. Other than details about life in the compound, what could these women provide us that's valuable?
Certainly their travels with Osama bin Laden. Obviously, who they met with, that type of detail.
And we don't think they went too far. We think they pretty much stayed in this compound.
They
for
could
five
have.
Years.
Who came in? You know, who saw him? Those types of basic details. But of course, the question is, will they get anything from them?
Yeah.
Will they
be told? Presumably, these women have been coached.
Well, absolutely. Just go in and sit with them for an hour. You know, say whatever, and then come on out. And now the Pakistani intelligence community has made their good faith effort. But what did we really get?
I see. So really, they're offering it up to us to get some sort of goodwill with the United States, but really, we won't get much out of it.
And this comes in the face of tremendous skepticism that how could Osama bin Laden have been living there for 5 years without support from the Pakistani government, at some level? In addition, which just follows, you know, KSM, Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, he was hiding in Pakistan as well. There's a history here. And so that's really what the intelligence community is trying to force them to say, hey, come on, you need to tell us all the information we can, because we've got this treasure trove. This is our moment to truly go after al-Qaeda.
You know, on the other hand, though, we don't necessarily know that these wives really did like their husband. I mean, he could have really offended them over the years. One of them was taken from her family, offered as a gift. Maybe they do have something to share.
I'm not convinced that the Americans coming in at this point in time and having burst into their home and always have been seen as the enemy are going to be the best people to perform the interrogations.
Is there somebody else who should do it? Can we get someone else to do it, someone from another country who might be able to get something out of them?
It may have been folks from Pakistan that they could have. Maybe they have a relationship. Let them do the questions. Let them have the right interpretation. Let them make sure that they get all the nuances and do it over time. Again, it's the accuracy of the information. Mm-hmm. That's really what you want to get out of all
this. So if you're asking them questions or showing them information, what do you want to share with them?
I want to share with them that we know you've been with them for a period of time. And there's been these activities. And what type of, how was the day spent? You know, the littlest piece of information can help to fill in some of the blanks that may be. Remember, they found all this information on disks and thumb drives and computers, hard drives. So what does that mean? Help put it into context as to how operational was Osama bin Laden and what type of communications was he actually able to make.
You're familiar with the culture over there. How likely were these women to have known about possible plots, contacts, people who helped him and aided him?
Obviously it changes, but for the most part, the culture doesn't necessarily have the same. You can't say that this is a Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton relationship where they're kind of partners in this.
No pillow talk here?
No, it's not likely, but nonetheless, that's not necessarily what they want. They want to know, again, how Osama bin Laden spent his life and these years, and what was he able to do, and who did he see? That's really, really key, because what you're trying to do here is get the whole network. And obviously, you'd love to have pinpointed information as to where operatives traveled to and from, but you might not get that.
All right. So I guess just take what you can get from
it. Right, context.
Michael Balboni, thanks so much. He was an advisor in Homeland Security to President Obama.